not speak a tongue, wherever you are, begin to blast the tongue. Who is demon? Who is Satan? To stand where God is standing, begin to blast the tongue. Meruna basu katana katore na bakasende duba ene kwatwa 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 kwatu corona baze zukatu kutadia marandu da batosia e kototo corona bagaza librando sakopa tore kapanekata mekupa tanuta sa mizoto pranutia renaku para. Wherever you are watching me, begin to speak it out now. As you are speaking, begin to share this broadcast. Invite your followers right now. Tell them the prophet is online. I want to prophesy. Begin to speak in tongues where you are. Lena dabo shakoli dabra dabo. Redeke sako tototo. Brebrebre renako. Barito sako. Mekuta le nadosa pranea. Rena koto korea. Basako toko renabusa. Ine koto. Ina duata kotoria. Zada dogo. Mekwato kalanduka patata. Ene tuka turia nabado. Zaza. Bredua sako liadonia, mekun petania, ekwata kototu, rigopa rekato, zatonia gadumba mata, inatusa, breliato senia no banaguria nama. Thank you, Holy Spirit of God. Thank you, Holy Spirit of God. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Quickly, child of God, wherever you are, I am here today to speak to your life by the divine instruction from God. I don't come online anyhow. I don't come online because I want to come online. Whenever you see me online, you should know that God has instructed me to go online. God has a specific and a special message He wants to pass across to His people. God wants to deliver just one person. Anytime you see me online, you should know that God wants to deliver just one person. So I don't just appear online because I want to show my face online. So whenever you are right now, begin to share this video, begin to share this broadcast, invite your followers now. Your miracles, your testimony lies on your sharing. If you're not sharing this video, you are not doing yourself a good at all. So begin to share this video, begin to invite your followers, tell them to come that the prophet is online. I want to prophesy. I am here to talk to people. I am going to give out the lifeline now. I want to prophesy. I want to do one-on-one prophecy. Are you hearing me? Because the whole world was created by prophecy. The Lord said, let there be this, let there be this, let there be this. So I want to speak to you by the divine instruction of God concerning your life. I want to tell you what God has for you. Are you listening to me? So wherever you are right now, now begin to share this broadcast. Begin to invite your friend. Begin to tell them that the prophet is online. Are you hearing me? But before we go into that, I pray for you. Lord, we thank you for today. Thank you for your children. Thank you for wherever they are watching from. Thank you for those of them whom you have kept alive to today. Papa, it's not because we are too good, not because we are righteous. Your mercy has kept us this today. Lord, we say glory be to your name. We say glory be to your name in the name of Jesus. Papa, we bring ourselves humble before you. As the fish cannot deny water, so we can never deny sin. I personally am a sinner. I sin against you every minute, every second. Lord, I use myself as a point of contact to reach out to my viewers, wherever they are watching me from, that your blood will wash away our sin. Your blood will cleanse us from our unrighteousness. I pray in the name of Jesus. You said if we say we have no sin, we make you God a liar and the truth is not in us. Lord, I beg you for mercy. I plead on behalf of my viewers. Lord, let your mercy speak. Temper justice with mercy. Lord, I pray in the name of Jesus. Lord, I give you praise. I give you glory. Thank you for what you are about to do in the life of your people. Thank you for the testimony. Thank you for the miracle. Thank you because you have sent me to come and pray for somebody. I am here to pray for somebody. I don't know who is fighting against your dream. I am here to bring back your dream. I stretch out my right hand towards you. Distance is not a barrier. The right hand of God is power. So receive God's divine right hand now. I pray for you that favor, miracle is coming upon you now in Jesus' name. God bless you, viewers. God bless you. Begin to share this video. Begin to share this broadcast. I want to talk to you quickly on a topic I titled, Who is After My Death? Who is After My Dream? Who is After My Dream? In other words, you can also put it like this, dreams killer. Who are those people that want to kill my dream? Who are those evil people that are running after my dream? I am here to talk to you, child of God, today, that your dream is very important to your destiny. Are you hearing me? The reason why you are still facing what you are facing today is because someone somewhere
is working against your dream. Someone somewhere is fighting against your dream. Are you hearing me? I'm going to just show you just one person in the Bible. You already know the story. Our brother Joseph. You know what happened to him? You know what happened to him? Because of his dream, his brothers hated him. They hated him. They fought against him. They tried to destroy him. Why? Because of dream. Why? Because he had a dream. What is that dream that you have? That your brothers and sisters are envious of? What is that dream that you have? That your friends, your co-workers are envious of? They are envious of you because of that. They have tied down your dream. You had a dream that this year you are going to buy a car. You had a dream that this year you are going to travel abroad. You had a dream that this year you are going to win an appointment. But the dream is not coming to pass. It's not coming true. What is happening? What is happening? What is the problem? There is someone somewhere who heard about your dream and is fighting against your dream. Those are the people that have come to deal with. If you agree with me by faith, say, prophet, I am tired. I want my dream to manifest. If you agree with me now and share this video, invite your people. I want to let you know those demons that are threatening your dream are going down now. Forget it. They must die now. The God of Elijah is the God that killeth and maketh alive. You already know my name. My name is Prophet Elijah Bamidele Ilugolo, the privileged senior prophet of Christ, House of Prayer and Deliver Ministry. I am here to release back your dream to you. That good dream that you had, that your family member, your brothers and sisters, they knew about the dream. And from that day, they have been fighting against it. I am here to break that shackles. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Holy Spirit of God. Thank you, Holy Spirit of God. Joseph had a dream. One of the problems we have is that we think that the people around us love us. Why? Because you have a very pure heart. So you now feel that the same mind that you have towards your people is the same mind that they have towards you. Unknown to you that the kind of mind they are using to follow you is a black mind. No wonder the Bible says that the heart of a man is desperately wicked. Wicked. They know that you have a good dream. You have a dream that you are going to marry this year. They had it. Maybe you told somebody, you told your brother, you told your sister, or maybe you told your father. Your father now told other people that my daughter says she will marry this year. They now took it up and said, not over a dead body will she get married. That good dream that you had that they are fighting against today, whoever that is fighting against your dream will go down. If truly I am a prophet of God, your dream will manifest today. Whether they like it or not. My friend, look at me. I don't pretend. I am not a pretentious prophet. You hear that, grandma? I am not a pretentious prophet. I don't pretend. I go straight to the point. I will tell you the way it is. I hate pretenders. Whoever that is after your dream, that is working against the manifestation of God's dream, of your divine dream, the dream to become who you have always wished to be, whoever that is working against it, whether the person is your father, your mother, your brother, your sister, your friend, your co-worker, whoever the person is, that person will die. As I read this verse, I decree the person will die. In the name of Jesus. This bell is not correct. The bell is not sounding well. Don't worry, my mouth is sounding well. I'll use my mouth. Hallelujah. So I am here to talk to you, Son of God. I am here to talk to you. You have a good dream. On the 31st of December 2019, you went to church, 31st night. So on New Year. So on the 1st. And you cried to God and said, Lord, this is my New Year revolution. This year, I'm going to achieve this. Yeah, the enemy, some of you, those evil people will follow into church. As you are praying, they are hearing it. Whoever heard your prayer and is working against your prayer, that person will die today. The only way your enemy will not die is if you did not share this video, is 50-50. Good tongue deserve another. If you don't share this video, forget it, your dream. Go still day by day. If you want your dream to manifest, oh yeah, keep sharing. Begin to invite your followers because I want to pray for you. Pray for your life. Pray for your destiny. That your dream that they saw that they are walking against, today you will know if I'm a prophet of God or not. Get ready. So join me as I open the book of Genesis. My spirit. Belu. Who's Belu? Who's Belu? I'm seeing a young man, Belu. Belu. The Lord said I should cancel the spirit of death. I don't know. Belu. Do I have anybody like that that's watching on online? Belu. If you are there, please signify. I want to pray for you. I'm seeing a casket. Belu. If it's possible, please snap your picture, send it around. Let me see it. Belu, you are tall, you are huge. Okay, chocolate complexion. I'm seeing a young man. I'm seeing a casket. Belu, I don't know. I need to pray for you right now. It is important I pray for you. Holy Spirit, I want to preach. After preaching, I prophesy. So if you are there, you are watching me now, begin to invite your friends because something is about to happen. Something is about to happen. I am not here to speak grammar. Demons, they don't understand grammar. The only language that demons understand is power. Hey, get out. That's what they understand. So I am not here to speak English. Follow me the way the Lord is leading me now. Are you telling me? Up for me. Join me, open your Bible. From the book of Genesis chapter number 37. Let me just read from verse 4. And when his brother saw that their father loved him more than all his brethren, they hated him and could not speak peacefully unto him. They saw that their father loved him. They saw that you have a good future, you have a destiny. They knew, they saw it with their spiritual eyes, that you are going to become something great tomorrow in the family. They knew it. Because of that, they hate you unnecessarily. In case you are watching me now, anywhere you go, people, they hate you. Not be your fault. The destiny you carry, your glory, they saw it. They don't want you to manifest that dream. That is why they are hating you. Whoever that hates you for no reason today, that person will die. Oh, this bell is not according to my ministry. That person will go down in the name of Jesus Christ. Wherever you are, begin to invite your followers. I want to pray by a prophet. Israel, we are delivered by a prophet in your presence. Any nation where a prophet is not recognized, that nation is dead. Any family where a prophet is not recognized, that family is dead. Any life, personal life, that does not recognize the office of a prophet, that life is a useless life. Quote me anywhere. Follow me. I'll take you to verse 5. And Joseph dreamed a dream, and he told his brethren, and they hated him the more. They knew that you have a destiny. Eh? They hate you because of the destiny that you carry. Now, the question I want to ask now is that, were you the one that created yourself? Were you the one that created? Was it not God that created you? Was it not the same God that created them? Then why did they not hate you? There is something unique about you that they don't like. There is something very unique about you that they don't like. Are you hearing me, child of God? If anybody is talking you down, anybody is saying bad things about you, anybody, people are criticizing you, they are spoiling you, it is because there is a seed, there is a mango seed that is about to be ripe, that they saw. They don't want that mango tree to ripe. That is the reason why they are spoiling you. They want you to be discouraged, so you cannot be able to get to where you will pluck that mango. Yes, my friend, I am here to tell you, don't be discouraged. They decrease. No matter. Focus. Your dream will come alive. Your dream will manifest. I am here to wait. Oh, I will throw this bell away. I am here to wake up your dream. Are you hearing me? No, look at all these people. Forget them. Forget them. You had a dream. Were you the one that stopped them not to dream? Why are they fighting against your dream? Follow me. Let's go to verse 8. And his brethren said to him, shall thou indeed reign over us? You see, he had a dream. Oh. He had a dream. that his brother's cattle were banded down to his cattle. Now, just another dream now you get. Listen, that dream that you went to tell that pastor. Some of you who are junior pastors, you are working with a general overseer, and you went to tell that they had a dream. Before you finish the dream, you already know the interpretation of the dream. There are some general overseer, they don't want their yoga wants to grow more than them. Please, keep your dream. Stop telling people your dream. Stop telling people your plans. This was the problem of Joseph. If not that God was with Joseph, Joseph would have, he would have ended up his life on the road. The Bible says, he that keepeth his tongue, keepeth his life. He that openeth wide his mouth, see you see destruction. He brought a stater. He did not know the interpretation of the dream. He only saw a revelation. And he told his brothers. They knew. They know the interpretation of that dream. They know. They said to him. And his brethren said to him, Shall thou indeed reign over us? Or shall thou indeed have dominion over us? And they hated him yet the more for his dream and for his words. They knew, you mean that I, Reuben, your most senior brother, will not come and worship you. They swear for you. Because of that, they hated him. They hate Joseph because of ordinary dream. The reason why people are hating you is because of your dream. Whom have you told your dream to? There are some people you should not tell your dream. If you tell them your dream, that we call them dreams killer. They will finish your dream for you. Look for people who have the same mind that you have. Look for men of God. There are some men of God, their heart is weaker than the heart of Satan. If you tell their revelation, they're not the interpretation of that dream. They will work against it that the dream should not come to pass. It's everywhere. Now let's read verse 8. Okay, 9. Now 8, I just read 8, Nabi. Now let's go to 9. Now, had he dreamt yet another dream, and told it to his brethren, and said, behold, I have a dream more, and behold, the sun and the moon and the 11 stars. He abandoned that to me. Now read verse 10. And he told it to his father and to his brother, and his father rebuked him and said unto him, what is this dream that thou hast done? Shall I and thy mother and thy brother indeed come to bow down ourselves to the earth? He had a dream. He only had a dream. Now, as I am talking to you right now, begin to think within yourself. Whom have I told my dream to? I want you to flash back. You had a dream. You had a plan. You have something you have in mind you wanted to do. And you went and discussed it with somebody. It could be your father. It could be your mother. It could be a friend, your brother, your sister, your uncle. Who did you discuss that good dream that you have with? Since you discussed that dream with that person, check your life. Have you been able to achieve that thing you dreamt of? Have you manifested that dream that you dreamt of? Now, listen, we are teaching together. I am not a pastor, I'm a prophet. So forget it. The way I speak the English, accept it like that. If you don't accept that, that's your hope. Accept the English the way I speak it. Just follow me because I'm here to deliver you. Are you hearing me? Now, follow me. Begin to think like that. Who did I discuss my dream to? Your dream can be your political appointment. Maybe you told somebody, I want to be a governor next year. I want to travel abroad. This year, I must marry. You said that last 5 years, last 4 years, last 3 years, last 2 years, last year, and you have said it again this year. Whom did you discuss your dream with? The person you discuss your dream with matters in your destiny. That is why most time
You don't tell your parents. There are some witches and wizards that are parents. I have seen this ministry. I have seen a lot of things. Mama, mothers are the one bewitching their children. Fathers are the one bewitching their children. Whom did you discuss your dream with? Who saw my dream? Who knew about my dream? Who is after my dream? Before anybody can come after your dream, one, they have spiritual eyes. They will see it even before you were born. Are you listening to me? Then after you not kept to life, as you are growing up, God gave you a dream, or maybe you have a good plan. I want to build this mansion. From that day, you went to tell that person that you want to build this mansion. Have you been able to lay foundation? Ask yourself this question. You saw a young man that want to marry you as a young girl. This thing is common among ladies. You went and told your friend, this man I want to marry, please, eh? I want to marry. Ah, God just connected me to a man who the man loved me, the man would marry me. See, the day you told that your friend, the marriage, Alpha, the pregnancy that God gave to you, you told somebody, have you been able to deliver the child? I've seen a lot of miscarriages. Let me tell you this story quickly of one of my daughters in the church. That lady is 38 years old. She was in a relationship with a man for 7 years. The man doesn't live in Nigeria anyway. The man lives in America. So he comes to me once in a year, twice in a year. So to cut the lesson short, they not plan to marry. They not, maybe she might be watching me now anyway. They not plan to marry. So when the fiancé came up from America, she went and introduced her best friend. She had been telling her friend about the fiancé. Then she now took the friend to her fiancé's house. He got there. Before the friend got there, she has already gone to Su Babalawo. Babalawo gave her itiro, this local eye pencil to put on the eyes. Immediately, the young man sighted the girl. All the attention, the love he had for his fiancé, was automatically transferred to his fiancé's best friend. They did, greeted, and they left. After they left, the girl came back. The lady suddenly just discovered that the guy was no longer picking his call. Her call. Wedding was arranged. Invitation card has been printed. Everything has been printed. He just discovered. To cut the long story short, that was how a friend collected the husband to be. The man took a friend to registry, the team registry, took her to embassy, to America. That was a problem that brought the lady to the church. I was ministering when God opened my eyes and I saw her. I said, hey, come here, you lady. I'm seeing a very big problem. I'm seeing a relationship that scattered. A friend. You told your dream to your friend. And you took your friend to your boyfriend's house. And that was the end of the relationship. She burst into tears after they cried. He cried, I cried. I said, this is not the time to cry. This is the time to pray. And I conducted deliverance on her. Serious deliverance. Vomited a lot of things. And I told her, if truly I'm a prophet of God from this altar, I set quarrel, trouble in between your friend and his fiancé. I set quarrel. And I told her, told the lady, 3 days fasting, God, let me not go to that side. That was how trouble started, though. Serious trouble between the man and the woman. The man said, he just woke up
and found, how are you? How did you get here? That was how the problem started. For you know it, the girl was repatriated back to Nigeria. The guy took care. Everything is, the guy says everything, lady had and went back and apologized to his original wife. That lady told a friend a dream. This thing I'm saying now is happening to so many of you. Somebody promised to help you. You went and tell another person. This was the problem of Joseph. Joseph thought that the people he called his brother and told his brother. He never knew they are enemies. Enemies of progress. Every enemy of progress around you. But the power in the name of Jesus made them run mad. Enemy of progress. They hated Joseph the more. They hated him the more. But let me tell you something, child of God. No matter how they hate you, no matter how they hate you, if your ways are right with God, that thing that they are fighting against will definitely manifest. I was to travel abroad some years back, I think about 15 years ago. I told some people, my family, and one of my family members called me and said, what are you going to do in abroad? Now people like you that they fight for abroad, if anybody must travel abroad, it is me, not you, Elijah. So you can't travel abroad, not in this family. The person told me eyeball to eyeball. That was how I ended up. I got a visa to travel to Qatar. Because I told people, the thing scattered in my hand. I got a visa to travel to Dubai. The thing scattered. I gave 850,000 to an agent who was supposed to help me do visa to travel to Canada. I'm talking about 2007. The agent ran away with the money and my passport till tomorrow. I know, sir. Why? Because I told people I want to travel abroad. Not everybody that wants you to travel abroad, though. Not everybody that wants you to marry. Not everybody that wants you to have a child. Not everyone that wants your company to grow. Not everyone that wants you to succeed. Not everyone that wants you to have a child. Not everyone that wants you to make it in life. There are people who are pretending as if they love you. The moment you open up and tell them your dream, that is the end of that dream. Child of God, I am here to speak to you as a prophet of God. From today, shut the door of your mouth. Do not tell anybody your dream again. We have dream killers around us. If your dream killer could be your mother, it could be your father, it could be your brother, it could be your sister. Look around yourself to open a wide. Your dream killer could be your husband. Your dream killer could be your wife. So be very careful and be sensitive in the spirit. Dream killers everywhere. There are people who will always make you same reason why you cannot, you want to carry this water. They will tell you, they will make you same reason why you cannot carry this water from here to this place. They will discourage you from carrying the water. Those kind of people are dreams killer. I used to have one of that in my ministry. My former resident pastor. Anytime I tell him I want to do this thing, he will always make me say reason why I cannot do that thing. We call them dreams killer. I am very strict. I'm very vocal. I don't care who you are. The young man is a pastor. He will always make me feel that daddy, you cannot carry this water to this place. Leave it here. We call them dreams killer. When I discover that this kind of person is, I no longer tell him things. Anything I want to do, I go ahead and do it. And I didn't know this was going to come out like this before. I say, yeah, that was the reason why I did not tell you. Because if I told you, you would have discouraged me. You have people like that around you. They are around you.
The best thing God tell them, provided you know that the dream you have is a godly dream, is aligned with the word of God, and your relationship with God is cordial, go and carry out your dream. Fight out your dream. Run after your dream. It will surely come to pass. Dream killers. Dream killers. They are worse than Boko Haram. Dream killers. They are worse than terrorists. Dream killers. They will be killing you and they said, I'm eating with you, drinking with you. Dream killers. That is why, whenever you have something good you want to do, child of God, keep it within yourself. Pray. Live a holy life. Make Jesus your number one advisor. Seek counsel from him. Lord, this is my dream. How do I go about it? Some of you, God is calling you into ministry. You are thinking, how do I go about it? You are telling people, God is calling me to ministry. God is calling me to ministry. They will work against it. When I wanted to register my church, when I wanted to register Christ House of Prayer and Deliverance Ministry, our church, I met a man of God, a fellow man of God like me, who has been in ministry for 5 years. Before I started, I said, I want to register my ministry. I'm having this good plan. I want the ministry to be officially registered. Do you know what he told me? He said, no, man of God. There's no need for that. Are you stressing yourself? There's no need for you to register your ministry. No need. No need for now, you don't need it. Maybe if your ministry is not going to 10 years, 15 years, you cannot register. He said, I'm not registering my own. It's okay. And I went home. I only went to see Castle, a senior colleague, who signed me and everything. So okay, let me go and seek counsel from him. Did you know that after I told him the following week, he got a lawyer and he went to register his ministry? It was after 3 months and I got to discover that he has registered his ministry. The same person who told me there is no need for me to go and register ministry. I said, okay, dreams killer. After I registered the church and I called him. Say, God have helped me, oh, I've done registration. Oh. He said, oh man of God, that's good. Oh. I want to tell you that the ministry, I've done my own. I said, Shabi, you were the one that told me that it's not good to register. I should not register to you. Maybe ministry has gone to 10 years, 15 years. So you are a bad friend. From that day, I caught from him. There are people that you should not welcome around you. They will always make you see reason why you cannot climb to the top. They will always make you see reason why you cannot travel abroad. They will always make you see why you can't have a child, why you cannot marry, why you cannot make money, why you cannot buy a car, why you cannot build a house. They will always make you see reason. I also have a brother for my father's family. When I was still riding Okada, zoom, 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 zoom. I wanted to rent 2-bedroom flat. He called me and said, 2-bedroom flat is too big for you. Go and rent 1 room, face me and face you. And I said, because I told you, I didn't want to give me the money. And I went, if you rent 2-bedroom flat now, family member will come and start living with you. And before you know now, your wife again will not have privacy. But if you rent one room now, only your wife, if they come to visit you,
and they discover that you are living in one room, they will go, they will not stay. But once you rent to the flat, and they will give you reason why you should not do that good thing you have in mind. Wicked people. I'm talking to you, my own family. This is my own. I'm telling you my own. And I called my wife, I said, honey, this is what my servant told me. Say, don't mind him. And we went and rented the 2-bedroom flat. I tell you, not rented the apartment in that cave. When he came, wicked people. You have them like that around you. We call them dreams killer. Don't allow them to kill your dream. Don't let anybody kill your dream. You have the mind to buy Range Rover Sport Jeep, pray towards it. Ask God for direction and walk your way out towards it. You will achieve that Range Rover Sport. You want to buy private jet, my friend? No need to discuss it with anybody, because they will make you see the reason why you should not buy private jet. You cannot buy private jet. How will you buy private jet? The park expense alone, sir. The money you will be spending to service it, we will buy 100 cars. There is no need. They will make. Whereas if they have opportunity, they will buy 10 private jets. Wicked people. This is why I encourage you, child of God. Don't allow them to kill your dream. Don't allow them to kill your dream. Anything I want to do now, I'll just go ahead. If you're opportune to hear it from my mouth, whatever you say, we enter here, come out from here. I will still do what I have in mind. Some of them will go to Babalawo, they will go to any diabolical means to make sure that they kill that dream. On the 16th of December 2016, when I heard a voice, Elijah, meet me at the Koyimate on the 1st of January 2017 with 2 passengers on Okada. When I heard that voice, I went home and I told my wife, I said, honey, see you. One voice is telling me to go to Matthew on the 1st of January 2017. And my wife said to me, say, honey, say, you know, you have been under the sun since morning. So your brain now is hot. Your brain is seriously hot. Yeah, go and rest. If I have listened to her, my wife would have killed my dream. He said, son has beat me, my brain is hot. I should go and rest. And I told her, I'm hearing a voice, oh, God is calling me, oh, hey, oh, dream killers. I'm telling you now. And I went, I went to bedroom. As well, like, no, I know. I went to bedroom and I went to bath. I ate the concoction jollof rice she cooked for me. But when I slept that night, the man appeared. When I started prophesying, when I went to Matthew, I came back and even my wife said, was that here on me? Are you sure that this here, hey, just now, you have become a prophet, you just go Matthew, come back, don't prophesy? I said, yes, now I see I'm old. And I give up my prophecy. Bah. You have a destiny, don't let anybody to discourage you. Dream killers are discouragers. Dream killers are discouragers. They can pass that demon can pass through your wife, it can pass through your husband, it can pass through your brother, your sister, your father, your mother, it can pass through anybody. Don't allow dream killers to discourage you of achieving that good aim that you have in mind. I was to travel to Jerusalem on the 18th of December 2019. I called some people and I told them, people that I was not supposed to get, and I told them. On the 18th, I carried my bag. I was to go to the airport to go and fly, and they called me and said, man of God, your date has been postponed. Yeah? And God said, to me, you get mad to talk. You have gone to tell some people and they have worked against it. He said, don't tell them again. Dream killers. See, I am very practical. I am raw. I don't pretend. go through our Facebook page. Most of my teaching, I use myself as an experiment to teach. My teaching are very practical. They are raw. I don't pretend. I don't speak grammars. Demons, they know me for that. That is why in their kingdom, they call me demon destroyer. I don't pity for demons. So I am not here to speak grammar. Hey, get out. That's my work. So forget it. I don't speak grammar. Share this video. Or else, no way for you. Your dream will not tell me that. Begin to share now. If you don't want your dream to die, share this video. Because I want to pray for you. I want to pray for you now. Enough is enough. How long will you keep struggling? How long will you keep begging? Do you know that in this hard time, this coronavirus that people are shouting, there are people who don't see it as anything. They don't see it as anything. Are you forbidden to be among those people? Are you forbidden to be the one that will be giving out food stuff to people? They bore you born poverty. Someone saw your dream and they are fighting against it. The time for you to arise now and fight those demons that are fighting your dream. That time is now. Forget English. This is not the time to speak English. This is the time to take it by force. During the days of John the Baptist, the kingdom of God suffered violence. And the violent men and women take it by force. This is the time for you to take it back by force. Taking it back by force. Your destiny, your glory, your marriage, your womb, your connection, your document, all those contracts, your visa, your appointment. This is the time, your health. This is the time for you to take it by force. This is the time. Oh yeah, take it now. Receive it, Lord. Take it now by force. Take it now in the name of Jesus. This is the time. As long as you are living a holy life, your ways are right before God. Forget it. Dream killers are discouragers. Dream killers are discouragers. So don't allow anybody to kill your dream, child of God. Don't allow them to stop you. That good thing you have in mind to do, this is the time for you to manifest it. Our God is not a wicked God. Jesus is still in the business of performing miracles. He's a miracle working God. He's still in the business of performing miracles. Do you know how many people this lockdown has given favor? They ask people to stay at home. Why some are getting connection? The time for your glory to shine is now. The time for your glory to move out for the world to see is now. Wherever you are watching me for now, begin to share this broker. Invite your followers now. Now! They can't stop your glory, they can't stop your destiny. Receive it in the name of Jesus! They tried to stop Joseph. If not that God was with Joseph, that young man's life would have ended up just like that. But the same people who said, "We can never bow down to you," they later came back and prostrated. Let's go. Go to Genesis chapter 15. There's no time. Genesis 15. Let us read from verse 16. Because those people that said your life will not move forward, they are coming to feed at your table. They saw your dream, they heard your dream, and they are fighting and working against your dream. They want to kill your dream. Don't worry, don't worry. Hold Jesus very tight. If you can hold Jesus on his trouser, hold him well. Hold on. If he said that you bless me, or we die here. That was what Jacob told the angel. If you refuse to bless me, two of us, we die here today. A man who has wrestled with man and God and prevailed, Jacob. This is the time. You will tell Jesus now, "Oh Lord, if you don't bless me, two of us, I will not leave your children till you bless me." Those people will come back. They will come. They are coming to apologize. The worst way go die remain. They are coming to beg you because many of them are going to die. The worst that God will give privilege to live to see what He has created you to be are coming to lie down. They are coming to prostrate. The only way they will kill your dream is if you Allow yourself to be ruled by Satan. When the wife of Potiphar wanted to seduce Joseph, the Bible says that Joseph fled. He fled. He ran for his life, his dear life. That was what took him to prison. He lived a holy life. Without holiness, my friend, there is no way that will just finish your dream. If you don't want them to catalyze your dream, if you don't want them to brutalize your dream, oh yeah, English. If you don't want them to finish you and your dream, my friend, run to Jesus Christ and give your life to Him now. Now. That was what helped Joseph. If not that Joseph gave his life to God in totality, in truth and the spirit, and run away from iniquity, even for that, the destiny and the dream of Joseph would have ended up halfway. He saw opportunity to sleep with his boss wife. Beautiful. I said, the woman in question is so beautiful. And the woman promised Joseph everything. If it now, some of you that are watching me now, sugar mommy, baby mama, baby papa, opportunity, sugar mommy, I've seen sugar mommy who is going to be taking care of me, pay my bills. They will pay your bills and collect your glory. There is a magician in my place that sang a song. He said, Osami Lord Boya Te na rehwe onguno. Hey, it's as if I speak in tongues, Abi. Now, how great the big person take to belefu in the heart? Why not bear it? Tell that baby mama, get him behind me, you Satan. If not that Joseph lived a holy life with God, Joseph would have ended up he would have ended his life halfway. But because he knew the dream, the revelation that God gave to him, he knew where he was going to, he knew that to do, he said, how will I commit this kind of sin against my master and God? If you are still living a life of fornication, adultery, adulterer, you are still doing charm, juju up and down, visiting one Babalawo house, your dream is dead already, you are finished. You are still doing 419, you are deceiving people, you call yourself a pastor, you use fake prophecy to collect money from people, you use fake vision to collect cars from people, like what woman of God told me, eh? My friend, if you do all those ones, your dream is dead. The Bible says there is a way that seemeth good to a man, but the end thereof is destruction. For your dream, for you to be able to actualize your dream, you need to live a holy life. If your life is not, you are not living a good life with Jesus, forget, your dream is finished. They will use your dream to drink beer in their evil beer parlor. But if you stand with God and say, Lord, it's me and you, forget it. No demon, no devil, no witch, no wizard. No babalawo, mamalawo, brotherlawo, sisterlawo can kill your dream. Why they have succeeded in killing so many people's dreams is because we have refused to live a holy life. Bible says that thing they said that they don't want Joseph to manifest, he later manifested it. Now watch. Before the death of the father wrote a letter. Genesis 15, verse 16. I read. And they sent a messenger unto Joseph, saying, thy father, Jacob, did command him before he died. Saying, so shall ye say unto Joseph, forgive, I pray thee, the trespass of thy brethren. Forgive their sin, for they did unto you evil. And now, I pray thee, forgive the trespass of the servant of God, of thy father. And Joseph wept when they spoke unto him. The father wrote a letter and said, Abel, forgive them. Have mercy on them. Please forgive. Before the father died, he dropped that letter. Immediately, Joseph got a message. He wept. Now watch. Remember the question they asked Joseph today. They asked him, Joseph, and his brethren. Genesis 37, verse 9, 8. His brethren said unto him, Shall thou indeed reign over us? Shall thou indeed have dominion over us? And they hated him the more. Eh? In verse 10, they said, in verse 10, and he told it to his father, and said to his brother, blah, 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 blah. And the father said, what is this dream that thou hast dreamt? Shall I and thy mother and thy brother indeed call to bow down? To bow down. Genesis 37, for verse 10. Eh? Shall I and thy mother and thy brethren indeed come to bow down ourselves to thee, to the earth? You want to ask him a question. So are you not telling us that me, your mother, your brothers, your elder brothers, you small boy, we are all coming to bow down to you? Now watch what now happened in Genesis chapter 50, from verse 16 to 17. 17. So shall you say to Joseph, okay, forgive, I pray thee, now, the trespass of their brother, their brethren, and their sin. For they did unto you evil. And now we pray thee, forgive the trespass of the servant of God, of thy father. And Joseph wept when they told him all these things. He wept. Now, follow me to verse 18. And his brother also went and fell down before his face. And they said, behold, we be thy servants. That thing that they saw from the beginning, that they were walking and kicking against, later came to pass. In Genesis 50, from verse 18, they went and bowed down. That same bowed down that the father asked him in verse 37. Chapter 37 from verse 10. Now came, after many years, they came and they prostrated to Joseph. They lie down with their face facing the ground. Child of God, can I pray for you? I don't know the person that is saying no to your dream. I don't know the demon that is fighting against your dream. I don't know your father, your mother, your brother, your sister, your uncle, your friend that is fighting against your dream. By the mighty of God upon my head, I prophesy, may coronavirus visit your enemies. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. May coronavirus visit those evil people who vow that your dream will not manifest, who vow that your dream will not shine, who vow to kill your dream. Coronavirus, visit them one by one. In the name of Jesus, in the mighty name of Jesus, whoever that say your marriage will not know peace, whoever that vow that your husband will not succeed, whoever that say that your children glory will not shine, whoever that say that your family will not live in good health, if truly there is God in heaven, and you are asking amen and sharing this video, I cause that person to die. In the name of Jesus, the Bible says, whatever I bind on earth shall be bound in heaven. I manifest in my office as a prophet of God, and I make a prophetic declaration. Wherever they have discussed your matter, any evil couple where they have concluded your case, and they say that your dream will not come to manifestation, if you shout amen with fire, I command that person to die, and I begin to release your dream right now. Those same people that said over their dead body will they bow down to you. If truly God called me as a prophet, I make a prophetic declaration. They will come and bow down to you. They will bow down to your God. They will bow down to your destiny. They will bow down to your finances. Whether they like it or not, you will be the one to feel them. You will feed them. I decree in the name of Jesus. The same people that said over our dead body, we will never bother to you. And the same people, willingly, nobody for them, they came and they prostrated for Joseph. They prostrated. They lying on the floor. And they said, we are ready to be your servant. You know, sir? You know, sir? And his brethren also went and fell down before his face. And they said, behold, we be thy servants. Behold, we be thy servants.
The same people that said, oh, you mean that we now will not be want to worship you? They planned to kill him. They sold him out. They put him inside hole. They did all manner of things upon all. They still came back. Let me tell you, sir, the destiny of God can never change. It can only be delayed, but it can never be denied. That you are going through what you are going through now does not mean that that is the end of your life. Child of God, there's a way out for you. There's a way out for you. Forget coronavirus. There's a way out for you. You will manifest that your dream. You will manifest that your destiny. You will manifest it. That your appointment, you will get it. That husband you want to marry, you will marry that husband. That America you want to travel to, you will go there. That money you're looking for, you will receive that money. Your company will grow. Your fish farm, you will grow. Those of you into family business, I pray for your family business. You are rearing chicken. You are rearing, goat. Whatever you are doing, as a farmer, I pray for you. Increase upon your business. Whoever that saw the dream of your farm that is fighting against it, I command coronavirus to visit that person. And I release a divine increase upon your farm, upon your chicken. Those of you that your eggs have been stopped down because of coronavirus, I decree customers. I decree customers from the north, from the west, from the south, from the east, even from the central. I release customers upon your farm, upon your business, upon your fishes, upon your chicken, upon your eggs, upon your feed. Receive customer, receive customer. Let me tell you, they cannot close that company. Whoever that is envious of your company and is wishing and planning to close it down, that person is a liar. I stand in my office as a prophet of God. I command that person to give way. Oh yeah, your company begin to grow. Your company grow. Your customers, whoever that saw the glory, the dream of your good customers, and is fighting to chase them away from you. If I be a man of God, I command that person to go 6 feet, and I release your customers. Oh yeah, receive your customers. Receive your customers. Receive your customers. Let me tell you, those eggs will not spoil in that company. Those chicken will not spoil. Those fishes will not spoil. Buyers are coming. I release buyers by the mandate of heaven. I release buyers. You want to travel abroad? I release your visa. You want to marry? Oh, yeah, carry your husband. Ah, I said carry your husband. You are married, your husband, and don't pay your dad. I release money upon the hand of your husband. You want a political appointment? This is your season. Nobody can stop your dream. If they could not stop the dream of Joseph, if they still came back and bow down to Joseph, your enemy will bow down to you. They will bow down to you. Your marriage will succeed. Your business will succeed. Your children will grow. You will carry that baby. You will carry that baby. Oh, yeah, carry your Samuel. Carry your David and Daniel. Oh, yeah, receive it now. In the name of Jesus Christ. From today upward, I prophesy, your head will never reject good thing again. Your head will never reject good thing again. Wherever you are, place your right hand on your head. And I make a prophetic declaration by the mandate of God upon my head. Any evil man that has been rejecting good thing from your head, as you place your right hand on your head, I command that man to disappear. I turn your hand to become the hand of Jesus. I turn your hand to become the hand of the Holy Ghost. I turn your hand to become the hand of God. You will break record in that family. You will break record in that family. That family you went to marry, that don't like you, they saw the dream, they saw the vision that you are going to help your husband to grow. Because that they are fighting against you, God will put them on your feet. God will put them on your feet. In the name of Jesus, the easy head get the crown. The crown of glory that God has placed on your head. Whoever that is under your crown, child of God, as you share this video, I call that person to go down. In the name of Jesus, with this anger in my spirit, I release your business. I release your destiny. I release your husband. That spirit of disappointment today, out! The mighty name of Jesus. No more delay. Even as you are told right now, even as you are told right now, no work, nothing, nothing, God will send you helpers. Elijah was alone in the bush. God sent an angel to come and give him food. I pray for you that God will send you angels. Angels of miracle. The day angel Gabriel visited Zechariah, his life changed. John came into his life. The day the same angel Gabriel visited Mary. Jesus entered her womb. I pray for you today. In order you can shout amen. Angel Gabriel, that is carrying good news. Oh yeah, he will visit you now. He will visit your marriage. He will visit your children. He will visit your academic life. He will visit your shop. He will visit your husband. He will visit your wife. Angel Gabriel, angel of good news. He will visit you today. Oh yeah, receive Angel Gabriel. 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 In the name of Jesus Christ. Receive Angel Gabriel. In the name of Jesus Christ. Receive Angel Gabriel. In the name of Jesus Christ. I decree in the name of Jesus. The seed came back and battered to Joseph. Does not matter what they have said about you or what they have said against you, that your destiny will manifest. By a prophet, Israel delivered. Let me tell you, sir, without a prophet there, your life is zero. God has put authority in our tongues. And as we say it in the name of Jesus, heaven confirm it. Every single prayer word has come out of my mouth today to you. Before now, to the next 72 hours, you will see the divine manifestation. You will see the divine manifestation. In the name of Jesus, I am not here to speak grammar. I am here to kill that your dream killer. That dream enemy, enemy of dream, enemy of good dreams, that don't want your dream to manifest. God of Elijah, the answerer by fire. Wherever they are, oh yeah, visit them. Wherever they are, oh yeah, visit them. Visit their enemy. Visit their enemy. Any foundational error that is working against your divine dream. If I be a prophet of God, concerning you, I command that foundational error to be corrected. To be corrected. By the Holy Ghost. By the Holy Ghost. Be corrected. Be corrected. Be corrected. Be corrected. Be corrected. Be corrected. In the name of Jesus. Coronavirus will not see your end. You shall see the end of coronavirus. You and your family will sing a new song. Child of God, begin to celebrate your victory. I see testimonies around you. I just saw the heaven open upon you right now. Those of you watching me right now, I just saw the heaven open upon you. I'm seeing the heaven. I can see the dews of heaven. I can see dews. Dews are falling. Dews are falling. Yes, dews are falling. Dews are falling. Dews of miracle, dews of favor. They are falling, 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 they are falling. They are falling, they are falling, they are falling, right now. Receive in the name of Jesus. 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 Never again will you cry. Never again will you shed tears. I decree my God will fight your battles for you. Wherever you are, begin to share this video, begin to share this broadcast, begin to invite your followers. Let them partake of this prayer. It is well with you. Are you sick? Are you going through some emotional trauma or what is that you are facing? Take your water. Jesus is the living water. Jesus is the living water. Lord, I lift up this water. I broke my head and I consecrate it to become the blood of Jesus. I consecrate it to become the blood of Jesus. I consecrate this water to become the blood of Jesus. I should drink this water now. Whatever represents nonsense in your life, your marriage, your business, your finances, your health, come out in the name of Jesus. I purify this water in the name of God the Father. I purify this water in the name of God the Son. I purify this water in the name of God the Holy Ghost. Jesus' mighty name, I pray. Drink your water, child of God. Tomorrow, I'm going to be on live again tomorrow. Connect, I invite your followers. The way the Holy Ghost has led me now, so I wanted to take some calls, but I will not be able to take calls now. But tomorrow, by the grace of God, immediately I start. I will only just leave prayer point. Make sure you are connected tomorrow. Tomorrow by 10 a.m. Nigeria time, 10 on the dot Nigeria time. I'm gonna be with you again. Are you hearing me, child of God? I'm gonna be with you again. 10 a.m. Nigeria time. Please write it down. 10 a.m. Nigeria time. Once I enter, start sharing. I will only just lead prayer after my worship song. I will lead prayer. After the prayer, I'll give out the lifeline immediately and I'll start speaking to people on phone. Are you hearing me? So we have taken the Holy Ghost have led me this way. So let's accept this one like this. If you have not shared this video, just remember that all the prayer I pray today is not for you. So share this video. If you want those prophecies and prayer that I prayed
to begin to manifest your life, share this video now. Share this video right now. Begin to share it now. Your sharing determines your glory. Are you hearing me, child of God? Don't forget that Jesus is the reason for the season. Is the reason for the season. Wherever you are, coronavirus will not see your end. You will not die. Remove fear from your mind. Nobody can kill you. Are you hearing me? No demon can kill you. No devil can kill you. Remember that Jesus is the reason for the season. Every day is a plus. Every day is a plus. You will see tomorrow. You will see next tomorrow. You will see next 50 years to come. Premature death is not your portion. As long as you believe and connect your faith to the faith of the prophet, forget it. Your life and your family is preserved. Remember this. To live anyhow is to die anyhow. God bless you.